out of the pocket. 7 seconds. 6 seconds. Murray keeps it downfield. It is caught. It is caught. DeAndre Hopkins.
Kevin Durant way outside. Delivers. Kevin Durant from downtown. It's a 6-point game.
To another episode of the Lewis Sports Network. It is your boy Lewis coming back at you once again with another heavy hitter banger with yet another video. Smash that like button, hit that subscribe button, make sure those notifications are turned on, make sure you guys are sharing this on your social media platforms. Truly appreciate it. I honestly was not going to do this video, but I decided to make it a bit of a quick one. Shout out to Bookie Allen for giving me the suggestion on the Scottie Pippen, Russell Westbrook, LeBron, and Kyrie video on the live stream in the comment section to allow me to do this video. So hope everybody's having a wonderful Friday afternoon going into the weekend. Hope everybody is having a wonderful, productive day. Stay blessed. Y'all already know from the Lewis Sports Network. On to the video. So Extremely Stupefied Peons Network came out with the top 100 list. Yes, the four-letter network, peak the acronym, on the top 100 players. This is what I got to say about this list. I don't really care for this list. You know why? Because they do this on purpose for clickbait. They do this on purpose to get people to overreact and people to create these conversations. I mean, I see guys like Bradley Beal is placed at 22. Ben Simmons is at 16. They had Lonzo Ball at 54, and they had D'Angelo Russell at 69. First of all, Lonzo Ball should be lower because at the very least, D'Angelo Russell has made an all-star team. Lonzo Ball hasn't even done that yet. But they decided to put Lonzo 15 spots ahead. So we got guys like Amin Hussein that this is just content creation, which is actually what I agree with. Nobody believes in this stuff. Nobody really cares. Well, it depends on who you're talking to, because there's certain fans. If you look at who, for example, LeBron and Anthony Davis are 1 and 2 in the league. There's people who will agree that LeBron is number one. Excuse me. I would actually have to put LeBron at number one because he just won the NBA title. Kevin Durant was not healthy this year. Also, Kawhi Leonard, you know, blew a 3-1 lead against the Denver Nuggets. Obviously, it takes a team to blow a 3-1 lead, and I get all that, but you know who's going to get the blame? The superstar's going to get the blame, among other things. So even though, again, we could play the blame game on a sum of parts when it comes to a basketball team. I'm not really looking real serious into this because, again, the only people who seem to care are the players. I don't know why. It's not just the players. The fans get into it. And again, the network, when they're looking at it, they're going outrageous. To be honest, you got to ask yourself this question. You don't think that these guys know what they're doing? I remember Kobe Bryant, I believe in 2014 and 2015, was ranked the 93rd best player in the NBA. Let's be honest. Even if Kobe's not in his prime, a healthy Kobe Bryant is no way damn near 93 on a freaking ranking. Look at that. I almost said that four-letter word, but y'all get my drift. So this isn't really serious, man. Honestly, I really don't care for it, honestly. You got Jay Williams saying, you know, I know he hasn't played in 2 years, but if you think they had John Wall as ranked the 81st player. Some people think that Zion is too high at number 20. I'm just like, that's what I'm talking about. And look at that, ladies and gentlemen. I just made a mistake. Zion Williamson actually sits at number 19 while Ja came in at number 31. He came in 31st. They got Jamal Murray at 21st. I think Bradley Beal was 22, like I mentioned. They got Russell Westbrook at 36. They got Paul George's number 20 because Bradley Beal is the 22nd best player. So this is what I'm saying. Like, it's just, it's inconsistent. Like, what do you expect? Like I said, they do this for clout. They do this to get you hot and bothered. They do this to get you to start talking that there's no way that this person is over this person. And the thing is, Extremely Stupefied Peons Network, they know exactly what they're doing. So the fact that they're outraged, it's like they know what's going on, okay? They just act all surprised and all this, acting like if they don't know what's going on. But they know. So this is not a big deal for me. And honestly, it really doesn't matter, because what matters is, it doesn't matter where you're ranked as a player. It matters what you do on the basketball court. That's all that matters, man. at the end of the day. So I'm looking at this list. I remember when they did the top. Remember when the top 50 greatest players of all time? You know damn well Isaiah Thomas ain't in no damn 40s when it comes to our greatest players of all time. Isaiah Thomas' proper ranking is 11 to 15, if we're being completely honest. Ain't no way he's in the 40s. There's no way. I mean, they had Steph Curry in the top 10 over, I mean, Steph Curry is not a top 10 player of all time, at least not as of yet. But the thing is, if you want to use that by opinion because it's a subjective argument, then fine. But you got to be real. Again, your accomplishments, your accolades, your body of work, they all have to come into play. The only way that you can put yourself in an all-time ranking is how much success you put in a period of time. If you're one of those people that established yourself and got many accolades in a very short time, you know, that's going to put you in rarefied air. And I always like to say rarefied air because, again, you're accomplishing things that would take most people a career to accomplish. You're doing this in very short time. So then when you add cumulative and then longevity on top of that, then it's like it looks even greater, and you could really stockpile your resume. But when you look at this NBA top 100 list, this is nothing, honestly. It's really nothing. Nothing. I'm going to get hot and bothered because Jamal Murray's 21st and Westbrook is 36, when we know that Russell Westbrook has been an MVP and multiple time All-Star. Like, Jamal Murray doesn't even have enough. He doesn't have enough, you know, career value to pretty much say that he's a better player than Westbrook. Maybe you could say right now. Who knows? Again, we don't know how whoever's making these rankings are ranking these. They might base it off of something. They might get selective off of something. But you know that there's going to be a certain bias towards it when it comes to this list. So now that I look at it, because remember, look how people reacted to the top 50 when I made that video. You know, I was just like, it just doesn't make any sense. But now looking at this, it's just like, that's the whole point. They get people to react, they get people to comment, and then they get people to, you know, it's another way to start another conversation. And in this case, it's kind of meaningless because, let's face it, if you're doing this by yourself, based on what you see, based on your eye test, you would know where you would rank these players more or less. And some of them have stronger cases than another one. And sometimes it could be very difficult to rank. So again, it is what it is, man. But this is the Four Letter Network, Extremely Superfied Peon Network's top 100 list. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your boy Lewis with another one on this video. Let me know what you guys think. As always, bless up, live, laugh, love. Thank you guys for watching.